Malam bertemu Menteri Pertanian dan Keterjaminan Makanan Mohd Sabu memberi jaminan isu perjanjian komprehensif dan progresif bagi perkongsian Trans-Pasifik CPTPP yang memberi kesan kepada sektor pertanian negara akan dibawa ke Kabinet. Menurut Ketua Koordinator Forum Kedaulatan Makanan Malaysia FKMM, Nur Fitri Amir Mohamad, jaminan itu dinyatakan Mohamad dalam pertemuan ketika penyerahan memorandum bantahan CPTPP.
Komitmen Menteri tadi dia kata dia akan berhubung dengan lebih lanjut dengan MITI lah. Jadi seperti mana Pak Lan sebut tadi, actually keputusan ni adalah keputusan Perdana Menteri dengan Kabinet, bukan MITI lah. Perdana Menteri perlu respon lah terhadap isu ni.
Nur Fitri bersama wakil daripada 54 pertubuhan bukan kerajaan NGO mengadakan pertemuan dengan Mohamad sekitar pukul 10.30 pagi ini di Kementerian Pertanian dan Keterjaminan Makanan Putrajaya. Pertemuan hampir satu jam itu antara lain bagi mendapatkan penjelasan daripada pihak kementerian berhubung kesan CPTPP terhadap petani, penternak dan nelayan di negara ini. Sebelum ini, Nur Fitri bersama wakil NGO menyerahkan memorandum terkandung 6 tuntutan agar kerajaan meneliti semula ratifikasi CPTPP yang dikhuatiri membawa kesan kepada sektor pertanian.
This is not just the issue of government. It's the issue that needs the support of the people. Saya mohon rakyat bangkit. Because benda ini pada kita, it is actually an enslavement program. Sorry to say, but that is the translation that we see. Tak masuk akal, benda-benda yang tak masuk akal. And I think rakyat kena bangkit already dan buat sesuatu. Alhamdulillah, this government is pretty supportive. I think so far is very pretty, looks pretty good. But we hope, you know, the rakyat will come together. We rally among ourselves to disassociate or to get out of this TPP.
Perkeliling that was signed by the government back then, I think Tun Razak time or Tun Mahathir time, that certain provisions of travel and printing will only be reserved for Bumiputera. It is now removed immediately due to the CPTPP. This is just one. So within the next few years or few months, you will see everything to be tallied, complied to the CPTPP requirement. And then you will see how CPTPP governs the Malaysia, not the constitution, not how we want to see it. Now the government and the new government needs to be free.
We did 1.24 trillion in 2021, right? Tapi dalam CPTPP punya cost and benefit analysis, nak capai 1.4 trillion in 2030. Tak banyak pun. Tak banyak. We're not going to gain a lot in export. Malah, our export is going to be reducing. It will be slightly increasing, tapi import akan lebih. So we're going to give it a lot. Jadi kita tak nampak the rationale of this.